The next step in AI apps is having agents do the work for you. I just came across this AI tool called Cofounder, and it promises to work alongside you with memory and intelligence. What I understand is it should be similar to something like Zapier or Lindy, but I'm curious if it actually is better. So in this video, we're going to test it out together. This is my first time testing out the tool. I'm going to do it alongside with you so you can decide if this tool is worth using. The website is cofounder.co. We're going to go through the onboarding together. So I found out information about me just with my name, which is cool. It probably looked at my name and email that I signed up with, and it just probably scraped LinkedIn and things like that. So my website, no code MBA, and okay, looks like there's an error with the business information, but I can just write it in real quick and say no code and AI education platform. So we'll continue. I guess the web search for some reason didn't work. Next, it needs email to understand writing style, understand the people I'm connected to. It's not going to send emails, and we don't train on your data. Okay, I'm willing to test it out, so let's try it. So now it's analyzing my email style. I think the one thing with these types of tools that's hard, especially for newer tools, is getting people to trust them to share your email with them, because you're basically trusting this company with your data, which is always hard when you're sharing something like your email. So it says my style, generally casual and direct, hey and hi, prefer concise, well-structured emails that get to the point, straightforward and conversational, casual closings, and excellent follow-up habits and customer service orientation, maintaining clear next steps. I would say overall that is accurate. Honestly, I am pretty impressed here with the example email that it created. All right, also wants to connect to my Google Calendar to understand availability. And they are not making this optional. So they are making users do this because they know it's going to make their product better by having more context. And then we can go ahead and continue. And then it also has memory, which is going to save preferences, conversation summaries, and knowledge from our tools. And you can add other integrations, such as Slack, things like that. But right now, let's just keep it as it is with Calendar and Gmail. Very nice onboarding so far. New feature where it can monitor a list of websites for updates like competitors. And then there's also some templates here. So I could just click that. Scrape our website for key product features, customer testimonial, value props, and generate 10 engaging tweets that highlight different aspects of our offering. So let's see what it comes up with this. So this isn't even necessarily a flow, although maybe we can turn it into a flow. So we can see it's using a web search tool to basically look up No Code MBA and more about it. And it looks like it also created this to-do list of tasks that it's going through. This is something that I've noticed Cursor does now. When you are AI coding, it'll create a task list. So it's cool that it's doing this, and it makes things more agentic. So it'll create the list, then it'll go through each step of the list one by one, which generally is going to get us a better result. All right, so it generated the tweets. And what I think it did a good job here of is doing the research, coming up with the angles that it wants the tweets to be about. The tweets itself are okay. I think that this is maybe where we need to give it a little bit more context or instructions, because I don't want hashtags. I also, it might just not, it's not exactly the style that I would want. But if you take the hashtags out, it's really not terrible. It's pretty good. And I like how it incorporated testimonials, for example. So it's not terrible. I would just take out the hashtags. So what I'm wondering is, can I turn this into a flow? So I'm just going to ask, would it be possible to turn this into a flow? Because I don't know exactly the best way to interact with this tool yet. Let's see if we can just do it all in one. And it did say it could. So that part I think is really cool. If you can ask it to do a task and then you realize, oh, this is something that we actually want to do on a schedule, then you could just do it whenever you want. So now it says it created the flow. So I'm curious. So it looks like it created it. And now I clicked on it, and now I'm in the flow editor. So you can edit your flow plan, ask with AI, test the flow, and see history and logs. So just to test this, so here I'm in flows, and now that flow is here, which you could think of almost like a zap, like an automation. What it's going to do, scrape the website, analyze the tweets, generate 10 engaging tweets, and do it. So to make changes to the flow, we can just literally in text update the plan, and that's going to make changes to the flow. You can also open this chat and describe the changes that you want. And then you can also just describe when it should run with triggers. So the types of triggers: recurring triggers, one-time triggers, condition-based triggers, for example. So condition-based would be like when I get an email about this or a Slack message about this, run this flow. So under trigger, I could say run the flow every Monday at 8 a.m., for example. And then I could say auto-approve, so it'll run without permission. And then now we can see we have this recurring next 8 a.m. at the next time that it's going to run. Now, this is also cool. It's pretty smart. So now it's saying, okay, you should add Notion, because connecting Notion will then give us a place for the tweets to be stored. You could also do Slack, for example, and send it into Slack. There's a lot of things that you could do here with this automation. So I'm pretty impressed with that, actually. So you could do that for a lot of different things. If we go back to the chat, we can see all sorts of other templates, and we can click down and see some of the templates. So for example, monitor competitor activity every Monday, check our competitor pricing, feature announcements and reviews, create a weekly intelligence report. And then this would be another thing where it could be a flow. Every Monday, it could send you an email with that information. Okay, I'm going to stop there. Overall, I think this is really interesting. I think that it's worth testing this out versus Lindy. I think Lindy is right now like the leader in this space. I really like using Lindy. In my first 10 or 15 minutes using Cofounder, I am pretty impressed so far. I like how it's very like natural language focus. So you just tell it what you want to do and it will generate the flows. There's not as much drag and drop in dealing with that. Maybe if you get to more complex flows, it could be a little bit harder to manage if it's not like Lindy where you can see exactly what's happening. But I definitely recommend checking it out and letting me know what you think. So leave a comment below if this is something that you would try yourself. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more free content like this, and we'll see you in the next video.